All right, so it all started back in Omaha, Nebraska, 1987. First time I ever touched a dog's dick. Never was the same after that. My name is the Gaslamp Killer from Low End Theory, Los Angeles.
Kutmah.
How did we meet?
I think we met before this, but the time I remember, it was my first time going to Orange County. I had a homegirl that was like, oh, we're having a backyard party thing. And you were DJing. I didn't know anyone there. It was a bunch of heads, people dancing. It was an ill record collection, so I was living through the collection. And I kept looking. I think you were like 19 or some shit. Dreads to his ankles. And he was just like, you know, just freestyling, playing Dilla beats, playing. I knew everything pretty much. And then after like an hour, I was like, all right, I feel like I know him through the music. So I was like, yo, what's this? And he looked down, he looks down at me, he's like, some shit. And he looked away and I was like, oh, this motherfucker. I was so pissed.
I was
pissed.
In the middle of DJ.
I know. But it was, I was really mad for a second. And I was like, okay.
Whose house was that at?
Mainframes.
Oh.
I was like, I don't know anyone here. If I raise up on him, everyone's gonna beat me down. So I just let it go. But
great. So the first time we met, you wanted to punch me in the face. I had no idea.
Early on in LA, wasn't a friend. Like, no one was being that. I mean, if I'm gonna be honest, it was really like, you know, going to like Good Life and shit. Those dudes weren't cool and shit. Yeah. They weren't nice to you.
Hip hop's not nice.
They wouldn't let you in, you know.
Hip hop's not nice generally.
Yeah.
You know, it never really was.
But then you play, and then they shut up because you're playing that real shit. That's my experience.
You have to prove yourself.
Totally.
You know?
And I love that. I want to prove myself.
Me too.
Like, doubt me. Keep doubting me, yeah.
Yeah. Coming from getting scraps thrown and negative energy thrown and shade thrown and just never feeling like anyone thinks you're great makes you work harder. You know, if somebody just immediately, the first song you put out and the first DJ set you do and everybody thinks you're a golden god. I mean, I can't imagine that kind of life. I wouldn't wish that on my worst enemy.
Fuck that, no.
Hello, my name is Alvin Genjai. I do have a middle name, but I don't really tend to use that. Just, it's a bit elongated. I'm 18 years of age, and my hobbies include like licking off head tops and taking elderly women out for dinner and making their husbands pay, which I haven't actually done yet, but it's just a hobby. The reason I'm on here, believe it or not, is because I'm looking for a housemate or a flatmate. Depends which way you look at it. But it's not a housemate because it is a flat, so it's probably a flatmate. Ideally, I would prefer if you're just a normal person, maybe not into yoga and avocados and veganism or anything. I just want someone who's not really a headache, just like chills out in life. If you listen to house or techno or like electrified stuff, I'd actually prefer if you didn't even apply, maybe just switch off the video. I would actually really like somebody who could maybe just enjoy a bit of sneakbo. Jet ski wave stuff, because if you see the hurricanes that I just think that his music is fantastic. So to have a roommate that could really, I mean, we could do like headphone splitters and share his tracks. And the reason I'm looking for a flatmate is because the person who was in here recently, he did get rude to me, so I snuffed his face. Like, moral of the story is that I need a new flatmate. He said he didn't like Sneakbo. See, it sounds, but like, you can't say you don't like Sneakbo, like my house. So my interests include skiing. And on Sundays, a lot of my friends kind of, for example, tend to do roast dinners. I just have some cereal. And I have this one friend, yeah, who pours water into, basically when he runs out of milk, he pours water into the bowl and puts it in a microwave. And I don't care who you are, what you do, like what your occupation is, innit? Like if you're gonna pay the rent, cuz that's what there is to it, really. All right, so yeah, you can be Chinese, black, or Asian, fam. All right, so what? It's £800, yeah, per consecutive month. You can, like, it's a single bed, but you can do double. There's a wardrobe in there, it's ready to go, but there's no balcony, just like open your window wide open, no garden or nothing like that, it's a flat. And yeah, like there's enough room to swing a cat really, but why would you want to do that? Plus you can't swing a cat because I'm not going to let your cat in, I just got.
We were digging in Miami and I found some shit I was exactly what I was looking for. This guy was insane. And then he found this J. Kane Company record and there's a song called Fly on it. And you found it, and I was really bummed because I found three records. I was like, you have enough psych records.
You found the Suicide LP,
found the Sealed Suicide Red Star record.
Self-titled, yeah.
And Iggy Pop the Idiot, which had the receipt from one of the guys from Danzig, bought the shit. It was super weird. It was like what the Kelly's Classics.
It's like a warehouse in the middle of Florida that was soaking wet, sweating.
Oh, his belly button was just a pool of sweat.
We had a joke about that for so long.
I asked him for the Suicide record. And I asked
God
him for
bless
the Suicide,
him.
Yeah, bless Kelly's Classics. I asked him for the Suicide record. It's this huge warehouse. And he's like, oh, try like the fifth box over there. I'm like, all right, dude. Like, it was in there. So anyway, but you found the J-Kin Company and I was pretty bummed. But I found it years later, but that was my initial like, I want that record, I want that record.
For me, Kutmah put the whole community up on Eden Abez, Eden's Island. It's an exotica record, super peaceful, spiritual record in the Moondog vein of things, you know, very, very, like special record to me and a lot of people. I still don't own the vinyl. I'm very jealous of you for owning that original record. Doubles!
Shout out to Ron and Poobahs for hooking that up.
Well, I'm gonna buy it one day. It's a holy grail eBay purchase. I'm just gonna buy it. But yeah, Eden Abez, Eden's Island. I still listen to it every day thanks to Kutmah. I honestly love that record from the bottom of my heart. It's such a spiritual journey.
Peaceful.
But it's also, it's very peaceful, but it's also deep and introspective and really meaningful.
And there's ill percussion and stuff on there. It's still. Yeah.
I love Exotica. That opened me up to Exotica for sure. That changed my life. I mean,
he was kind of considered the first hippie, really, even though he got roped into the Exotica sort of genre.
Right.
But he was the first, he lived under.
He was on some beatnik type stuff.
Yeah, he lived under the Hollywood Boulevard sign eating peanuts. While he had money, he wrote Nature Boy for Nat King Cole in 1949. So he had money, but he's like living under the Hollywood sign in a white robe. Guys, there's photos with him for, what's it called? The Beach Boys with, Brian Wilson. Brian Wilson, and there's pictures of Eden in there. Mm. So it's like he was in those sessions. So you know, with his wisdom, he dropped something on him, you know?
Damn.
Yeah.
Und immer einen Schritt weiter ist. Schluss, was du sagen willst, bevor du weißt, was du sagen willst. Bleibe still, damit du nicht vor Wut ausbrichst. Vor Wut dann sprichst, damit du vor mir gut aussiehst. Sie sagen, meine Eigenart ist eigenartig. Ich hab nur eine Eigenart. Ich muss mich nicht kleiden wie sie. I have a dream, ich bleibe real. Das hier ist meine Party. Nächster Party, nächster Party. I'm feeling myself, feeling mich selbst. Ich bin kein Alien, mein Außenseiter mittendrin.
Leila Akinyi ist ein Mensch, der in Afrika geboren ist, ein Mensch, der viel gesehen hat, viel erlebt hat und ein Mensch, der in Afrika geboren ist, aber in Europa aufgewachsen.
Ich trage ihre Uniform nicht. Jede Rede ist glaubwürdig. Ich trage ihre Uniform nicht. Lieber träume ich, erneu mich, bis ein Rekord bricht. Yes. Ich trage ihre Uniform nicht. Religiös ist nicht gleichgläubig, nicht dem Volk.
Es ist ja oft so, dass man im Leben in eine Richtung, also dass man dich in eine Richtung bringen möchte, so sei es in der Schule, sei es im Kindergarten, also von Geburt an. Deine Eltern, deine Freunde, die Umwelt, die Umgebung, alles ist, will dich formen, will dir was einreden und will dich in eine Richtung lenken. Und ich wehre mich dagegen, so, weil ich was anderes bin, weil ich was anderes sein möchte. Ich möchte aussuchen, wer ich sein möchte. Ich habe lange überlegt, auch immer, wie soll ich schreiben, was soll ich schreiben, und habe am Ende gemerkt, so wie auch bei Elend, es ist, am besten kannst du nur du selber.
Burning Man is the strangest place to play a show. Burning Man.
I couldn't imagine what that's like.
Both of us
have been
to Burning Man,
but I haven't played.
And it's the greatest festival in the world and one of the most incredible experiences I've ever had in my adult life. Playing Burning Man is like a biblical experience, life-changing, earth-shattering.
I bet.
Like, people still write to me all the time, every single year, asking me when I'm coming back. Never had a more devoted fan base that I could ever have gained, besides Low End Theory in LA, than Burning Man. There, I played in a 747 cockpit that the plane had been cut in half and only the cockpit remained, and they put turntables in the front, took off the window. So I was playing in the front of an airplane with the wings outstretched to 40,000 people in the middle of the desert in, you know, 10 Celsius. In the middle of the night, with people on every drug imaginable, and also sober people, and also people proposing to each other during my set, people getting married at the freaking festival while I'm playing. I mean, like, you'd never imagine the levels there, the depth of weirdness and amazingness.
Totally.
But weird on a cheeky level, festival, they are kind of a British Burning Man, but more of a music festival. And they asked me to play in a 100-foot-tall hydraulic metal spider sculpture where the entire spider is standing over the festival and it looks, you know, very Burning Man-esque. We'll shake each other's hand right here without knocking over the vinyl.
Like business shake?
Nah, like hip-hop shake, but not, we can't hug.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Of course.
Just a handshake. Cool? Mm-hmm. Business shake?